Today we will be doing an experiment to find the focal length of a convex mirror using a convex lens. Apparatus needed, optical bench, four uprights, convex mirror, convex lens, meter scale, pins, lens holder and mirror holder. Apparatus required, you have an optical bench, a meter scale, you have four uprights, you have a lens holder, you have a mirror holder, you have two pins, you have a convex lens and you have a convex mirror. Try to focus a distant object on the screen so you can move the lens towards the screen, and here we can see that a sharp image is obtained on the screen and the approximate distance at which the sharp image is obtained is around 18.5 centimeter. So the rough focal length of the convex lens is 18.5 centimeter. A convex mirror has got a virtual focus, so calculating the focal length by usual method for a convex mirror is not possible. Therefore, to calculate the focal length of a convex mirror, you have to use the convex lens. This is the setup for finding the focal length of a convex mirror. So you have got four uprights. In these two uprights there are needles, and here you will have a convex lens, and here you will have a convex mirror. So the convex mirror is placed at this side after the lens, and here you have one more upright, and before the convex lens you have one more upright. Suppose a convex lens makes the image of an object AB, now this is the object AB, at C on the other side of the lens. If a convex mirror is placed in the path of the rays between the lens and the image, so this is the path of the rays, so the convex mirror is placed between the path of the lens and the image, the refracted rays will fall on the convex mirror. So these are the refracted rays, they will fall on the convex mirror as shown in figure A. Now this will result in reflection of the rays, so the rays are reflected back here and a real and inverted image is formed which coincides with the object AB at point O. So at point O you get an inverted image as shown in figure A. Now in this case the distance between the pole, that is the center of the convex mirror, and C is equal to the radius of curvature, that is R. So this distance will give us the R. Using R we can calculate the focal length for the given convex mirror by using the relation F is equal to PC divided by 2, where PC is R, therefore F is equal to R by 2. The convex mirror is placed at a marking of 42.8 centimeter on the optical bench. After finding the rough focal length of the convex lens, place it on the optical bench. Now here we can see that it has been fixed at a marking of 55 centimeter and secure the upright with the lens holder by tightening the screw. So here it is at 55 centimeter. Now keep the object that is put in the upright at a distance of 1.5 times the rough focal length of the convex lens. The rough focal length of the convex lens was found to be 18.5 centimeter. So 1.5 times of this focal length is 27.5 centimeter. So it is 55 plus 27.5. So approximately that means you have to keep it at a distance of 82.5 centimeter. So here you can see it is 81, 82 and 82.5 centimeter. That means now this object is placed within the range of F and 2F, because till F it is 18.5, till 2F it is 37. So now we are keeping it at a distance of 27.5, so that means the object is placed between F and 2F. Now if you check here, you can see that the inverted image of this needle through the lens after being reflected back by the convex mirror. So the tip of the image needle and this object needle should coincide with each other and move together across the diameter of the mirror, which means that there should be no parallax error. But here, right now, there is a parallax error. So you can see that here now there is a parallax error. So you have to move the object to and fro along the optical bench and try a convenient position and also make lateral adjustments if needed so that the parallax error is removed. By making the necessary adjustments, by moving the upright which holds the object needle along the optical bench, we have found a convenient position of 84.6 centimeter, and at this particular position the parallax has been removed. So you can see here the parallax has been removed. As we shift the position of our head to the either sides, the both the tip of the image needle and tip of the object needle, they move together across the diameter of the mirror, which means that the parallax has been removed. After removing the parallax error, the next step is to remove the convex mirror from the optical bench and place it away. Now try to view through this side of the lens the inverted image of the object pin, and now the tip of this pin held in this upright and the tip of the image pin that you see through the lens should coincide with each other and they should move together. Now right now here they don't move together, that means there is a parallax error. Now I have to move this to and fro without changing any of the adjustments of the lens as well as the other upright, making them as stable as possible. I have to shift this to and fro along the optical bench and find a convenient position where the parallax can be removed. Right now here there is a parallax error. Now you can see now there is a parallax, and this parallax has to be removed by making necessary adjustments by moving this upright along the optical bench. After making the necessary adjustments, see that the parallax is removed and note down the reading here. Now here we can see the reading is 2 centimeter. See that the marking of this one is not taken into consideration, the marking of the lens position is not taken into the consideration. all we have to take into consideration is the marking where we had kept the convex mirror and the position of this upright where we had removed the parallax. To find the radius of curvature of the convex mirror, we have to note down the distance between the position of the mirror where it was kept and the position of this needle from where the parallax was removed. This distance from the mirror to this one will give us the radius of curvature, and half of this will give us the focal length of the convex mirror.
Approximate focal length of convex lens is equal to 18.5 cm. The convex mirror was placed at a position of 42.8, so position of convex mirror P in centimeter is 42.8. Position of the image needle, which is denoted by C centimeters, was 2, as we had found. Now the radius of curvature, R is equal to distance between mirror and needle, R is equal to P minus C centimeter. Therefore 42.8 minus 2, so you get 40.8. focal length F is equal to R by 2, so F is equal to 40.8 by 2, so you get F is equal to 20.4, which we can take it as F1, so F1 is equal to 20.4 centimeter. To take the second set of reading, we will follow the same procedure, but here the position of the convex lens will not be changed. As we had kept it at a marking of 55 cm, we will keep it in the same position.
To take the second set of reading, again take the convex mirror, place it on the optical bench. Now you can keep it here at a reading of approximately 47.7 cm. So here, now this has been kept at a marking of 47.7 centimeter. Similarly, from this side, again note down the readings when the image seen through the convex lens and this upright needle touches tip to tip and the parallax is removed. So here right now we can see there is a parallax. So make necessary adjustments by moving this upright to and fro and try to remove the parallax. Now here you can see there is a parallax. You can see a parallax is evident here. So by moving it to and fro along the optical bench, you can minimize the parallax error and completely eliminate it. Now by making the necessary adjustments by moving the upright along the optical bench, now the parallax has been eliminated and the noted position on the optical bench is 86.6. So for 86.6 marking, we have eliminated the parallax. Now the tip of the image needle and tip of the object needle actually coincides with each other. Now remove the convex mirror from the optical bench, keep it away. From this side, try to view the inverted image through the convex lens. As said in the previous procedure, the tip of this upright and the tip of the image seen through the convex lens should coincide with each other and they should move together meaning that there should not be any kind of parallax error in them. So now you can see that there is a parallax error right now. So by moving this upright to and fro along the optical bench, you can minimize the parallax error and completely eliminate it. So after making necessary adjustments by moving it to and fro along the optical bench, now we can see that the parallax error has been minimized to a larger extent, and the reading on the optical bench is around 5.5 centimeter. For the second reading, we had seen that the convex mirror was placed at a marking of 47.7 centimeter. Position of the image needle, we got it at 5.5 centimeter. Radius of curvature, R is equal to distance between mirror and needle. Therefore, R is equal to 47.5 minus 5.5, we get 42.2 centimeter. Finding the focal length, F is equal to R by 2. So F is equal to 42.2 divided by 2, we get 21.1 centimeter. Mean focal length, in this case, since we have taken two readings, F is equal to F1 plus F2 divided by 2 is equal to 20.4 plus 21.1 divided by 2, that is 41.5 divided by 2, we get an answer of 20.75 centimeter. For the third reading, again place the convex mirror on the optical bench at a different position. Note down the readings. As said earlier, from this position, check out for the coinciding point of the image and this upright needle. By moving it along the optical bench, try to remove the parallax error. Then in the next procedure, remove this convex mirror, and from this position, try to see the image through the inverted image through the lens. The image needle and this upright needle should have their tips touching tip to tip, and then make adjustments by moving it along the optical bench and even making finer adjustments by giving lateral adjustments. Remove the parallax error. Result: the focal length of given convex mirror, F is equal to 20.75 centimeter.